Thank you.
Spices?
Yeah.
No,
no.
That chicken, no
spice.
Oh,
this
chicken
with spice.
No, I'm sorry.
I like it. Oh, you like spicy? Oh. Okay.
Tell me,
this is the one with spice. She's from Chile. This one, spicy. That chicken, not spicy.
The Prime Minister thanked those officers and men of the Sierra Leone military forces who have remained loyal to the government and who have done so much to bring the present difficulties to a solution. He said, it is for all civilians to give every possible help and encouragement to these our military brothers in their difficult task, and to bring to the notice of the authorities any person who by word or deed attempts to stir up dissension and conflict in our midst. Dr. Stevens added, it is our duty both as civilians and soldiers to do everything possible to see that calm is restored, so that the men can go about their work, the women about their business, and our boys and girls can continue to go to school. He urged all to tackle the present crisis with zeal and put the nation's interests above everything else.
My dear compatriots, fellow citizens, brothers and sisters of Sierra Leone, our beloved country, Sierra Leone, has faced quite recently a crucial moment in our history. As you know, a group of soldiers, led by ambition and greed, tried to upset the constitutional regime, which Sierra Leone has rightfully and freely chosen. In doing so, this group of soldiers and officers, together with a bunch of abominated politicians, wanted to introduce violence and anarchy in the country. To confiscate and retain the government power in order to show that brutal force prevails over reason and common sense. A coup d'etat means plain illegality. For nowhere in the Constitution is it stated that a group of men should substitute themselves for the true representatives of the people, the guardian of sovereignty. My dear countrymen and women, as you know, Parliament has voted full power to the government, which I have the privilege to lead. It is clear, therefore, that all those who have tried to trample down the legal regime are outlawed. As the Prime Minister of the country, who holds his functions from the will of the Sierra Leone people at home, and who freely and lawfully appointed me, I will defend legality by all means, at any moment and in any circumstance. I know I can rely on the support of all friendly African states and that of all other states in the world to safeguard legality in Sierra Leone. But my first help, my first support, comes truly from the people of Sierra Leone itself. In this condition, I will not permit and I will never tolerate, without forsaking my duties as the Prime Minister, that a clique of men without mandate should assume power. Brothers and sisters of Sierra Leone, dear compatriots, I declare solemnly today that I would rather die for my country than accept that a bunch of people should try to govern this country by force. I know I have the great majority of the people and of the army on my side, and that they are faithful and loyal to me. I hail them. As I've already mentioned, I have received full powers from Parliament. These full powers, I urge every Sierra Leone citizen to use them for our benefit, so that we restore law, justice, and reason over brute force. People of Sierra Leone, last November, our sister country, the Republic of Guinea, was aggressed. On this occasion, the people of Guinea stood as one man to safeguard her sovereignty. This victory, which Guinea achieved, the people of Sierra Leone can also achieve it over troublemongers of every kind. Since the last OAU meeting in Lagos, which dealt with the aggression against Guinea, a problem has arisen, which has been discussed. It is that of organizing the common defense of Africa by the very Africans. For this reason, the government of Sierra Leone submitted to both the government of Liberia and Guinea a project of the common defense treaty. The three countries have agreed in principle on the subject. But due to the serious events which took place in our country, the government of Sierra Leone, through its prime minister, and the government of the Republic of Guinea, through its president, have signed the treaty. We are sure that within a short time, the government of our sister country of Liberia will join Sierra Leone and Guinea. Fellow countrymen, so I have the great honor and the privilege of solemnly announcing to you that from this very moment, the armed forces of both Guinea and Sierra Leone have become one, are ready to crush all those who might attempt against peace and security in our two countries. People of Sierra Leone, stand up to defend in unity and concord our sovereign rights and our future. I call upon the workers of Sierra Leone. I call upon the youth and the women of this country to stand united beside the government. I call upon the people of Sierra Leone to crush mightily all enemies of freedom and progress in Sierra Leone. Long live the people of Sierra Leone. Long live African unity.
Ted, I want to tell you that by doing this recording for Sierra Leone, you have made for posterity some irreplaceable memento in our nation's history. Thank you for the work you've done. Thank you for serving Sierra Leone. Thank you for the work you did with the Peace Corps. And above all else, thank you for preserving the recordings that made me famous. Thank you very much.
Hey, Zach, wake up!